Hi, I'm Dr. James Machino. I want to talk to you today briefly about statin drugs. Statin drugs are used, as you know, to lower cholesterol. And I personally believe that they're being overprescribed. I say that because studies show that 90% of people can get their cholesterol into the ideal range with diet and lifestyle alone. And doctors don't emphasize this point enough. When a person's cholesterol is rising, they're very quick to write a prescription for a statin drug, where in many cases they could be using diet and lifestyle as the first intervention. So the question is, how do statin drugs actually work? Well, they block the production of cholesterol in the liver, and so less of it gets into the bloodstream. So that sounds like a good thing. So, you know, but why is cholesterol being turned on in the first place? It's synthesis. When you eat saturated fat, trans fats, deep fried foods, then it turns on cholesterol production. And this is really where the problem is. And so the way that it works is this way. Once those fats get absorbed and they go to the liver, in order to get out of the liver, to be transported through the bloodstream to the different tissues that will use that fat, the liver has to make cholesterol to sort of help to transport the fat, if you will. So then as the fat is being transported through the bloodstream, the cells are able to pick the fat up, and either the fat cells will store the fat or muscle cells will burn the fat. But then what's left in the bloodstream is the cholesterol. That's the bad cholesterol known as the LDL cholesterol. Your body can't burn cholesterol. These are not calories that tissues can burn. People say, I can eat those fats because I burn them off. You might burn the fat off, but the cholesterol remains behind. And if you make too much cholesterol because you're eating too many of those foods, that cholesterol can lodge in the wall of the artery and narrow the artery over time, leading to atherosclerosis and an increased risk for heart attack and stroke and kidney damage. And you know the rest of the story. It's the leading cause of death, is that people have too much cholesterol plaque in their arteries. So when you take a statin drug, you block the synthesis of cholesterol in the liver. But when you do that, you sort of trap fat. Now the fat can't get out of the liver because you need the cholesterol to transport the fat. And so as fat accumulates in the liver cells, it can damage the liver cells. And when the liver cells are being damaged, liver enzymes leak into the bloodstream. So when doctors put patients onto statin drugs, they have to monitor their blood to see if any liver enzymes are leaking into the bloodstream, because they know that that's a major risk. So it sounds a bit dangerous because it is a bit dangerous. The other thing is that statin drugs have been shown to damage muscle tissue and lead to a lot of muscle pain, and can actually cause kidney damage as well, sometimes a life-threatening type of kidney condition. In fact, some statin drugs have been taken off the market because they had a significant correlation with a very lethal type of kidney failure. And so, you know, I really believe that diet and lifestyle is being underutilized in many cases, and I want to bring this to the forefront. Now, to be fair to statin drugs, there are some people that absolutely need to take them. People that have strong genetic high cholesterol problems, and they're easy to identify, and it's only about 5%, maximum 10% of people with high cholesterol. They need these types of drugs to get their cholesterol down. People that have other high risk for cardiovascular disease, they've already had a heart attack or a stroke, then I appreciate the importance of statin drugs in their management. But for the rest of us, diet and lifestyle should be the primary things that we rely on. It's the safest way to go, and it's been shown to be very, very effective. So that's where I come in. I would strongly recommend that you download my cholesterol-lowering lifestyle program immediately and act on the strategies that I present there, because they are the ones that are evidence-based. Now, at machinohealth.com, you can see all my published research papers, other videos, footage from my live professional seminars, other downloads, other resources I created that will help you lead a long, healthy, functional life. My review articles and teaching materials are complete with all the scientific references to and make sure that you're getting only evidence-based information on any health topic that you're searching, so you know you're on solid scientific footing. So be sure to make machinohealth.com an ongoing reliable resource of health and wellness information for both you and your family. Thanks so much for watching.